Hello everyone, Vitaly here with Hertz Drums. In this video, I'll be showing you two methods of replacing the kick drum audio in your live drum recording with a drum sample in Reaper. The real-time method and the MIDI-item method. We'll be using Hertz Drums as our drum sampler. In Reaper, we'll be using a stock plugin called Audio to MIDI Trigger for our first method, and a free extension called MK Slicer for our second method. I'll be doing it on macOS, but the process will be the same on Windows, apart from some minor details. Okay, let's dive right in. Here I've got a Reaper session with a live drum multitrack. Let's hear what it sounds like. Now, let's say I wanted to replace the kick drum with a sample from Hertz Drums in real time. So whenever the kick plays, it's automatically replaced with a sample from Hertz Drums. To do that, I'll first insert a new track, call it Hertz Drums, and load Hertz Drums onto this track. Now let's go to MIDI mapping and see what note the plugin is using for the right kick. It's C1, but we actually need to know the MIDI number of that note. So let's insert an empty MIDI item, open it, and find C1 on the keyboard. So the note number is 36. Now we can just remove this item because we won't be using it anymore. Okay, so I'll be using this kick-in track for hit detection. Let's open Track Effects and type in Trigger. And this is the one we'll be using, the JS Audio to MIDI Trigger. Let's open it up. Now in this MIDI note field, I'll type in the number of the kick note, 36. So now whenever the plugin detects a kick hit in the audio, it will send out our selected MIDI note. Now we need to send this note to Hertz Drums. To do that, you can simply drag this routing icon from the kick-in track to our Hertz Drums track. A config window pops up, where you can choose what information you're sending to the Hertz Drums track. So if you want to be able to process both the original kick audio and the sample together with one plugin chain, you can leave it as it is, and send both audio and MIDI to the Hertz Drums track. If you want to keep them separate, you can disable the audio and send just the MIDI information to Hertz Drums. In this case, we're sending the original kick audio to the master bus, and the MIDI information goes to the Hertz Drums track. Now we need to set the threshold in the trigger plugin, so I'll pull it all the way up, and we'll be slowly lowering it until I hear all of the kick hits detected by the plugin. Yep, at minus 10 it works just fine. Now it's not sending out the raw signal, but you can blend it back in with the mix slider. Now, if you want to create a new MIDI item from the kick hits and be able to detect those hits more precisely, you can use a free Reaper extension called MK Slicer. To get MK Slicer, you will first need to install Repack and SWS extensions for Reaper. Go to the official Reaper page, reaper.fm, then to the Resources section and select SWS Reaper Extension and Repack Package Manager. On the pages that will open, download the correct versions of SWS and Repack depending on the operating system you are using. Once the downloads are completed, open up Reaper, go to Options, and select Show Reaper Resource Path. This will open Reaper's resource folder on your hard drive. You can close Reaper for now. Next, go to the User Plugins subfolder, grab the repack.dylib file that you've just downloaded, and drag it to this folder. Then open the SWSDMG file, and drag this Reaper SWSDYlib file from here to the User Plugins folder as well. Now, before we reopen Reaper, there's one macOS quirk we need to deal with. I don't think it happens on Windows, but on macOS, you need to go to System Settings and open the Security Settings section. Now keep this window open and open Reaper. You'll get a bunch of security warnings, but don't worry, it's perfectly fine. macOS just doesn't trust you. So you need to hit OK in each of these warning windows, and also hit Allow Anyway under the same warnings in the Security Settings. When Reaper loads, close it and reopen again. This time just hit open two times and hit OK in this window that pops up. From now on, Reaper will be loading normally and the extensions are ready to use. So you'll see this new extensions menu here. Open it and go to Repack. Select Browse Packages, type in MK, and you'll see this MK Slicer extension. right-click on it and select Install, then hit Apply. You'll get this installation confirmation and you're good to go. Okay, now let's say I want to blend in a kick sample, or completely replace this kick with a sample from Hertz Drums. Let's go to Actions, Show Action List, type in MK, and select MK Slicer. It opens the slicer window. So now we need to feed our kick track to the slicer. I'll be using this kick in track, so I select the audio item and hit Get Item. Now first things first, you need to make sure you're working in the trigger mode, which is the right mode for drum hit detection. So here you've got your kick audio, and these vertical lines are the points where MK Slicer will insert MIDI notes. And as you can see, not all of the hits are detected. So to fix that, when I'm working with a kick drum, I usually set this low pass filter to around 55 Hz, so it makes it easier for the plugin to detect the hits. I also increase filter gain just a tiny bit. It's looking much better already, but take a look at this. This is a kick ghost note right here. Listen to it. It's barely audible, but I want it to be there too. So now I can play around with the threshold and try to find a sweet spot where it detects this ghost note, but doesn't react to the snare hits in between. Yeah, this looks just about right. Now, another cool feature of this slicer plugin is that you can set the velocity range of the MIDI output. I don't want it to go all the way up to 127, so I'll set the upper limit to 107 and the lower limit to around 40. It allows you to choose the output MIDI note from this list, so I'll stick with B1. Now just hit MIDI, and it will insert a new track with a MIDI item on it, with all of your kick hits. Now let's load Hertz Drums on this track. On the MIDI mapping page, we can now change our kick note to B1. And we're done. Now let's hear what it sounds like. It sounds pretty cool already. And especially I like the sound of that ghost note. It's still subtle, but just a bit more audible. So that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Leave a comment below if you got any questions. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more drum mixing tips. See ya!